This is the mountain gorilla, a highly intelligent and peaceful creature. As of spring 2010, their numbers have been estimated to be less than 800, but they are now protected by the African government. A full-grown adult male gorilla can weigh more than 200 kilograms and reach heights of 1.75 meters. Females are smaller and weigh on average half that of a grown male, reaching heights of only 1.4 meters. Gorillas have an average lifespan of 50 years and tend to form very long-term bonds between males and females. Newborn gorillas are tiny and helpless, often weighing no more than 2 kilograms at birth. They are dependent on their mothers for up to 3 years and remain with the group as they continue into adulthood. Females reach maturity at 10 to 12 years, with males taking a little longer at 11 to 13 years. An adult male usually becomes a silverback at around age 15, when the hair on his back begins to turn gray. Like human fingerprints, gorillas can be identified from their noses, with each individual having a unique nose print. Gorillas eat mostly plants, though some insects as well, and spend their days mostly foraging and feeding, rising at usually 6 a.m., resting around lunchtime, and then back to eating until the evening, when each night they build a new nest to sleep in. They usually sleep for 12 to 13 hours a day. Like humans, when the weather is cold and rainy, they tend to linger in their beds longer than usual. The leader of each group, known as the silverback, protects the entire group from all threats. An experienced silverback is capable of removing hunters' snares from the trapped hands or feet of group members. He also determines where the group forages for food, and he will mediate any internal conflicts between members. The silverback is usually the center of attention during rest periods, with the youngsters often staying close to him and even including him in their games. All members of the group will play with the infants as they learn more about the workings of the group and gain the skills needed to survive. When a mother dies or leaves the group, it is usually the silverback who will look after the young she left behind, even allowing them to sleep in his nest at night. Even though the gorilla is extremely powerful, with the silverback being 10 times stronger than a large, fit human male, it is by contrast a very gentle creature who rarely shows severe aggression or fighting. When a conflict does arise between two silverbacks, the fight is sometimes to the death, using their long canines to puncture deeply into their opponents. As big as they are, gorillas have some interesting fears, like that of water, reptiles, and even caterpillars, and they will go to great lengths to avoid contact with water. For example, if there is a creek to be crossed, they will often do so by crawling on a fallen tree instead of just wading through the water. The dwindling numbers of the mountain gorilla are affected by a number of threats, including pollution, habitat destruction, agriculture, disease, and sadly still today, poaching. They have been killed for their feet, hands, and even heads, sold to collectors around the world. Infants are sometimes captured and sold to zoos, researchers, and incredibly, even to people who want these majestic creatures as pets. The abduction of an infant often results in the death of at least one adult, as they will fight fiercely to protect their young. As gorillas share so much of their DNA with humans, but with no history to have built up an immunity to any of our diseases, even the common cold, if caught by a gorilla, has the potential to wipe out an entire group. They are also susceptible to other diseases, like those found in livestock, transmittable through contaminated water sources near the gorilla habitat. It's easy to see that these incredible animals have a mountain of obstacles between them and survival, and only with our continued efforts to protect them will they remain a part of the African landscape. This is the mountain gorilla.